Will GitHub Copilot X make you a better developer? That's something that we're gonna find out in this video. I will tell you a few things about it, including 5 great features that you can use in your daily life as a coder. And at the end, you can decide if that's something for you. So let's begin. GitHub Copilot X was recently announced. And for those of you who have no idea what that's about, basically it's some artificial intelligence that helps you to write code in your IDE. The project GitHub Copilot was first released last year in June 22, and basically it's a collaboration between Microsoft with GitHub and OpenAI, and it uses AI to help you as a coding assistant. As I saw in a blog about the people that used the first version, about 46% of their code was written by ChatGPT Copilot. And also, their development was faster by 55%, which sounds insane. As GitHub said, it recognizes what code the developer has typed, the error messages, and also is deeply embedded into the IDE. And I wonder how this will work when it'll be released. If you want to test this, there is a waiting list where you can sign up. And you can use some features from it, but not all, just some. You can think about this version as a beta or a technical preview. Basically, you have some features to work with, but it's not open for the public. There is still some more to be done there. Lately, there were a lot of AI releases, and a lot of people are wondering if those AI tools will replace programmers. And the obvious answer is no. But most likely, what will happen is that those skills will be a must in the job description. So for the future, if you don't want to have any problem in finding a job, basically you should keep up with all the changes and learn what will help you. About the price, at the moment is $10 per month and $90 for a business. And my belief is that you should buy one for at least 1 month to test it, to see what's there. And after the end of the month, you can decide if you can keep it or not. Now it comes the question, what it can do. So the first thing will be the chat window, which can help you to easily ask for example of code, like for example a pop-up of ChatGPT that's inside your IDE. A good example will be to ask it to refactor some code, or maybe you have some HTML that you want to translate into Vue.js component. And I'm guessing here only your imagination can be the limit, I guess. Here you can also have multiple questions and get an answer for that. Basically, it's similar to the ChatGPT, where you have a question, you receive the answer. You have another question, you receive an answer based on the previous question. So basically, it's similar to a real person communication. Finding, debugging, and asking for specific code. You can select some code and ask for a specific description about it, about what's there, or why it's not working how it should. I'm curious how this will work in the real life. An example here, let's assume that you copy some code from Stack Overflow and you want to know what that code does and how it works. Next will be that it can help you with a description for your code for a pull request. Maybe you won't work with just tab, tab, tab and submit, as it says on the website. But if I can get some useful information and to use it in my own style, that's good enough for me. I'm thinking in a similar way as the previous point where I told you that you can get a description for the code that you copied from Stack Overflow. Basically now that description will be in the pull request. Step by step, I don't know why we still need middlemen called developers. The fourth thing will be the Copilot for CLI, which will be quite useful if you're not a guru in the terminal. Here I have an example from their official page where you can get some help to create a watermark for your media file. And also, in this case, you will get some details about it. At the end, you will be asked if you want to run this command. The last thing will be voice to code AI. And at this point, I can imagine having my personal for coding in VS Code. You only need to ask what you want to build and done, it will do it for you. If you don't like what you got, you can simply ask to replace the code. You can also use multiple commands like go to line 34, go to that method, go to the next block. I can imagine in the future having an office full of developers that it looks exactly like a call center. That's pretty much all for now. So to answer the question, will GitHub Copilot X make you a better developer? Depends what your image about this. A developer should memorize all the comments and functions, or maybe a developer should know what to ask and what to search for. And the memorizing part will be just a thing for something else. Or maybe a developer should just be fast at coding. Yeah, basically that's a question for you. But you can drop a comment below. I wanna know how a good developer should look like. Basically, what's your image about a good developer? That's all. Till next time, stay safe.